love one.
Watch Lee Ho Ching play. She is also kind of soft, similar to Doo Hoi Kim in the sense that she doesn't have a big finishing shot. They just grind away at you.
Yeah, Liu Jun is the junior, in a way, of the three. When she played Junipa Sawetabut against Thailand, she actually lost 3-2. She would tend to just play the one match. She did bounce back against Algeria. That's a nice forehand. Beating Melissa Nasri 3-0. Had a day off against Chile and then came back against the US, beating Emily Tan 3-1. And then played second time. That was the one time that she played twice. Tiffany Kerr, she won 3-0. And she was involved in the crucial tie yesterday against India, beating Aika Mukherjee 3-1.
For Hong Kong, China, this is so, so important because Jun Yijing is going to play that fourth
yes.
match. And she is that top 10 player, and she's expected to take two.
Good work here from Lee Ho Ching. It's certainly a little loud on the Hong Kong side when they win the points, isn't it?
They know this is, they really need this to stay alive. Lee Ho Ching is so vocal already. She's actually usually a quiet player. Sometimes I would almost characterize her play as sleepy in the way that like it's difficult for the other player to get energy to play her. But today she's really full of spirit.
Great shot from Lee.
Lee Ho Ching keeping everything very high quality, like all the more defensive shots, low to the net. Umpire asking Lee Ho Ching to throw the ball straight in the air instead of towards herself.
Well, it worked.
Yeah, she was unfazed, Lee Ho Ching. It's like, okay, thank you. Thanks for the reminder.
Lee Ho Ching got her campaign off with a win against Jia Liu, 3-0 against Austria. 6-2 in favor of Lee Ho Ching at the moment. Seven out of the last nine. Against Australia, she beat Michelle Bromley 3-0 as well. And then thrashed Mathilde Pinto also by 3-0.
Six,
she goes 3 points clear. Angelina Orunovskaya, she won 3-0. It's been a very, very good event for her. and yesterday defeating Susanna Viglos, also 3-0.
Oh, that was some really nice blocking. Great touch. This is the most spirited I've seen Li Ho-Ching in a long time. She knows this is her job. She really needs to win this third match.
Well, she's just reeled off points for fun, Li Ho-Ching. Very, very impressive in the latter stages of that previous game.
We heard from the bench, be prepared. Your opponent likes to play long ball, so back up a bit sometimes.
Well, look, if she wins this, Du Hoi-Kem, I mean, Du Hoi-Kem in theory will be, on paper at least, the underdog against Zheng Yujing.
Yeah, it's an uphill climb.
It is. So important here for Li Ho-Ching to win this. Perhaps push it to a fifth if Zheng Yujing, if it goes according to form.
And I think that's Hong Kong China's plan.
Right.
They're going to say, I'm not going to worry about Zheng Yujing. We got to pick up the other three.
3-1.
Li Ho-Ching playing more aggressively. We're seeing the rallies come out.
Yeah, which we barely saw in the last game.
Last game was actually very technical, like very close to the table, not a lot of big rallies.
3-2.
Yeah, a lot of sort of glancing upwards and not looking too happy, Li Ho-Ching.
Like, oh, how did I miss that? Ugh. Right. Li Ho-Ching is really putting pressure on Li Ho-Ching. It's like each shot has just a little bit more rotation. It's a little bit shorter. It's just a little different. And Li Ho-Ching feeling like kind of frustrated.
Yeah.
These are my shots. Why aren't they hitting? So annoyed. You know, that's some of the talk that you might have in your head.
Yeah, again, it's a... She looks really irritated.
Yeah. I should be making these. What's going on? Get it together. That's what you might be thinking in your head. I think players are their own most critical coach.
That's more like it from Li Ho-Ching.
Great work there. High quality. So technical. It's Li Ho-Ching really placing the ball well. You know, we're not seeing the rally because Li Ho-Ching is placing the ball super well on the receive.
Deep shot there from Li Ho-Ching. Might feel a little happier now. Much better from the Chinese Taipei player.
She's still looking as defeated. If she's not that happy with it yet. She knows there's a lot of work to do.
Let 4-7.
Thank you. brilliant run here for Li Yuchun. Yeah, very good run for Li Yuchun.
Yeah.
Suddenly, she's in the ascendancy. Liu Qing under pressure.
Under a lot of pressure because Hong Kong China really needs this match. Liu Qing finding her form.
Yeah.
No, we get into the rally now. She's making the shots. Previously, she wasn't even getting in here.
It really has gone the way of Chinese Taipei Li Yuchun, who's up 6 of the last 8.
5-9.
See Li Yuchun's body language, like, I need to be making these. Every shot that's gotten me here, this is what I need to keep doing, and I'm capable.
6-9.
The progression continues under Li Yuchun.
Net to come over, change the pace.
Couple more points, Li Yuchun, to make it 1-1. And she's got 4 game points now.
Li Yuchun finding her form truly. A much more aggressive, much more comfortable, much more confident.
Yeah. So much better for Li Yuchun. Just take a little pace off the ball. We'll just see if that works here. Yeah, she did try on that penultimate shot. Just to take a little bit off it. These shots will be a touch shallower. That's not going to come on to Li Yuchun. Now that it's 1-1, you've got to start looking at this a little differently, perhaps. If Chinese Taipei can win it, then this really gives them a good shot, you would think, of finishing this in 4. Because, as we said, Zheng Yuqing is the favorite against Du Huikem, on paper at least. Mind you, Chen Ziyu was the favorite earlier, and we saw how she got outplayed by Du Huikem. Great shot there from Li Ho-Ching.
It's going to be toe and toe this third game. This one might be the pivotal one for the entire team tie.
By 2 here, Li Ho-Ching.
Two, five.
Great 5-3
now. Oh, best rally in a while. Liu Qingde up by 3.
Form. Both, we can see in the arena, both teams are on their feet. Both players playing their best. What a big rally to win. This could be the game that determines this entire match. Especially looking at this kind of form.
Well, this one could be one of those that goes the distance.
I feel like we've really stepped it up a level. These last couple points, both players know how important this game is.
Yeah, I was just going to say, they know how crucial it is right now. Liu Qingde there, just trying to force the issue.
She's trying to play very, very aggressively. And sometimes that can lead to overplaying.
Yeah.
Oh, that balance is so difficult. Table tennis is the sport of the margin. Precision.
8-4.
This is looking good for Liu Qingde. It's working up very, very nicely for Hong Kong here.
Liu Qingde is really in the zone, in her element. Very calculating right here, thinking hard about exactly where she wants to place those serves.
5-9.
Barely a response from the Chinese Taipei bench at the moment. She is in a difficult position.
Okay. They're like, okay, good start, but let's see.
5-9.
That's a bit better. Can she embark upon a little fight back here?
Right, and Liu Qingde thinking, okay, I need to reset a bit. When Liu Qingde is given some free balls, or they're not under heavy pressure, she can be very good. Liu Qingde needs to keep the pressure on.
10-6.
Oh, and she's won quite a few points.
4 yeah. Game points for Liu Qingde. Excellent work for Liu Qingde. It's a good comeback from her.
One lock.
Liu Qingde looking all business. Zhou Chun, Liu Qingde's forehand is so good. Liu Qingde advised to stay away from it to attack into the backhand. Good work there.
Nicely done that. Li Yuchun.
Li Yuchun's forehand is so strong. She sets it up perfectly here. And just a quick turn and boom, finisher. That's what Liu Jun needs to do. Set up these third ball attacks. Here we go, just finish it into the middle.
Yeah, she hasn't been able to do that on a consistent basis, has she?
Yeah, not really. We see some streaky times and she's able to execute that. But credit to Li Hoqing, playing very aggressively.
Jun wins this. We're going to go into a fifth. That will be a whole different ball game.
We're just going to watch Li Yuchun and see if she can attack with her forehand. If she's able to do that, she can win this. Li Hoqing making it very difficult for Li Yuchun.
How about that for a backhand?
Time out. Five, six.
Renewed determination, perhaps, Li Yuchun, as she comes out of that timeout.
And she did great following those instructions, open to the middle. Wow, the Hong Kong China
bench. Really loud, aren't they? Really loud.
You can watch them in this replay. They know how important this is. This is their most critical match.
Chinese Taipei, I feel that they need to be also kind of pushing back a bit. Let's see what happens when Yuchun wins her next point.
Six,
right now, it's Li Hoqing.
Li Yuchun seems almost surprised how many balls are coming back. She's like, I thought I won. How did it come back again and with such good quality? I thought I got it. Critical moments for Chinese Taipei.
Three in a row here for Li Hoqing.
It's important to note that in that timeout, Chinese Taipei said the strategy is working. As long as you don't miss your own shots, you're okay. But there was a bit of urgency in that voice.
She just looks a little disheartened here.
The body language says it all. How did I miss that? Li Yuchun makes me feel like someone who feels like she's not playing her level.
Yeah.
You know, she feels like, I can do so much better. I'm just frustrated at myself and at such a critical moment.
Well, she needs to up her game quickly here. Otherwise, she's on the brink of defeat. That's a better backhand shot.
Do or die.
Yeah.
So much power in that. Just take a look. She just kills it. I saw a grimace on the Hong Kong China team's coach's face, like, not going to get that point.
She was on the attack there, Li Ho-Ching. She's got two match points.
It's interesting, the contrast between the two benches. I think for Chinese Hong Kong, or Hong Kong China, they know they have to win this, basically, to stay in. Chinese Taipei have a couple more opportunities.
The urgency is there, isn't it, for Hong Kong China. So Li Ho-Ching, it's a